demonstrating a clear difference between darkness and light based on Revelation chapter 3 verses 15. And that is NIV for those who want to know the fashion so that we may be together. So Revelation chapter 3 verse 15. And I would like if to the side of the so that we move fast, because time is also moving very fast. Kama utakuwa pale unasema and there, and I allow you to read. Chapter 3, verse 15. The Bible says, we'll start, let's start from 12. Yes, from 14. Let's start from 14. To the angel of the church in the nation, write. Listen, write this. These are the words of the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the ruler of God's creation. I know your deeds, that you are neither poor nor hot. I wish you were either one or the other. So because you are lukewarm, neither hot nor cold, I am about to spit you out of my mouth. Praise God. Amen. That part's the topic of today. God says, I know you are this. They are not new to you. I know. You are neither cold or hot. I wish you are one of these. But therefore, if you are not one of these, I will spit you out of my mouth. This is exactly how I will say the situation is like as we talk. Not only in the glory chapter, but in the body of Christ as we talk. You are not cold, neither are you hot. You cannot be known where you are standing. Ama kunaenda mbele, ama unarudi nyuma. Haujulikani. This is to the Christian. This is not the non-Christian. This is being told to the Christian. Me and you. And God says, I know. So we are hidden, thinking that God doesn't know. But he tells us in Revelation, I know your deeds. I wish you would stand and be known that this is you. When you will turn this way, it is still you. When you will turn the other way, it is still you. And when you will turn the other way, it is still you. There is no confusion. Balance of you. So, if we are struggling and want to pray, and we are asking God, yes, we are facing this situation. I know Corona is just that in everybody's mind, and we have different types of praying and asking God this and that and that. But before you go and pray to God, listen to this. He knows you are needy. Ask yourself, when I'm going to God, ask him whatever issues, talking about the situation, the pandemic, and all that, and all that. Know that God knows your needs. It is up to you to ask yourself whether you are hot or cold. As a Christian, this is not for those who are hot, those who do not know Christ. It is for me and you. Now let's look at a scripture, which is our main scripture. You will just write Ezekiel 39. 21 to 23, and somebody go there because I will come back there so that we may read to get exactly what the text is saying. But then we are going to look at, let me repeat, if you are writing, write Ezekiel 39, 21 to 23. But we are going to look at two types of rebellion. And we all know that Satan repairs. and tried to compete with God and was thrown down to earth. Isn't it? So that is rebellion by those who do not know anything about Christ, neither do they confess, they don't want to associate, they deliberately denounce, and they say God does not exist. Total rebellion. So whether you are you are praying that God save this world, yes, God has the power to save this world, but there are those kinds of people. And then that is, if you want to refer, then examples are Genesis 19, 6, 11, Exodus 1, 8, 10, and even Daniel. In fact, this is a very classic case. Daniel chapter 1, verses 1 to 6. And in chapter 5, the same Daniel, 25, that is where a hand wrote on the wall because of King Nebuchadnezzar, who had profaned, who had repelled, who had purposed to go against God. Using the things used in the temple to glorify God, to go and do pleasure with his people, and to do merry with his people, using the same. And a hand wrote on the wall. And the writing was many, many tekel b'rissim. That is, it's been measured and you've been found wanting. That is rebellion by those who God doesn't care. They don't care whether God exists or not. Now let's go to rebellion by those who know Christ. By me and you. That is the second type of rebellion. So you ask yourself, do we rebel? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. And last Sunday, for those who are here, I remember telling you that Daniel said, from the scriptures, Daniel had read the scriptures, and he was drawing whatever he was praying about, whatever he was doing, from the scriptures. And we are drawing this rebellion from the scriptures, that we Christians have also rebelled. So rebellion by those chosen people of God, that is the nation of Israel, the children of God. That is Exodus 32, 1, and you can extend 2 to 4. What is happening here? Remember, the children of Israel, without going into that text, you will go read for yourselves. God, the children of Israel, waited for Moses for how many days? When he went to the mountain. And it is as if it was so long, and they said, to hell with Moses. Hello, make us gods who will lead us. Gods with small g. Whatever happens with Moses, we never know. Maybe he will never come back. And therefore, we want gods who will lead us. We do not want anything to do with Moses again, and maybe with the God of Moses. And Aaron said, yes, I will make you gods. Bring your whatever, earrings, bring your bangles, bring whatever. And he molded a calf for them. That was the rebellion of the children of God. And at this point, I want to say this. Moses is a prototype of Jesus Christ in this situation. And let me not go into the details of what I've just said, but it's just a type of Jesus Christ. And because of that, I'll not go into the details of that, but that's not that. Then, the thing is, I want to bring us to speed that this is what is happening right now. Not to the Lord Chapel alone, but to the body of Christ. Jesus is gone for 2,000 years, isn't it? And he promised to come back again and take us, isn't it? But some of us are saying, to hell with this man Jesus. Maybe, we don't know, he may not come back. We know, we're not even sure. Even, in fact, we did not even see him. So my pleasure, my body, which I will see, which I will caress and embrace. My desires dwell with this Jesus. I don't know. So, let us indulge. And the world, the dark world, is very influential. He's looking at you when you are getting confused. He's looking at you and me when we do not really have that touch with Jesus Christ. And I say we have a second option. And the second option is how much I will put, how much I will invest in terms of currency in my bank account. How much I will trouble over other Christians to prove how much strong I am and to show how much I can speak to you. Do we care about the widows? Are we responsible about the monies that we've been given, public money? Do we care about orphans? Do we care about reading the Bible so that you can come close to Jesus Christ and know exactly what God is saying? Do we care? I'm not condemning you. I'm saying it's not a little chapel. It is across the board. And at this point, I want to mention something. What do you think about your brothers and sisters who are in another continent, and in this continent, they are saying, we don't want to hear anything to do with Christ in their schools. We don't want to hear anything to do with Christ being told to the children. If you tell your child to follow Jesus Christ, the child sues you in a court of law. What do you think? As a Christian, should there be a concern? Should there be a concern? Yes, there should be a very big concern. In fact, a very big concern for that matter. In fact, we should go down and pray for such. And that is what is happening right now as we talk. Here in Kenya, we are neither cold or hot. Ukipenduka hivi haijulikani ni wewe. Ukifanya hivi, it's just like we don't know. From down there to the, I remember one day Pastor Brian saying, we are blaming our leaders. We are saying, oh, they are doing this. They were bred from down there. Wakienda juu. Baka wafike kwenye wako, alafu wana manifest exactly what they have been learning and what they have ingrained in their hearts and in their blood system. So Jesus gone for 2,000 years. You are not sure whether he'll come back. Jesus gone for 2,000 years. We are not even reading the Bible to come close to him. Jesus gone for 2,000 years. We hear voices that look like they are telling us about Christ, but they are not. And we cannot even go to verify what are these people really speaking. What are they saying about Christ? So we hear that voice, we hear the other voice, and we hear this voice, and at the end of the day, we don't know where we stand. And I want to tell you, it's not even Nicholas, it's not Nicholas, it is this one. I can use this for my own benefit. I can use this to manipulate you, to get to meet my desires and meet my ends. But it is up to us to go back here, because through here, God talks to us. And that is why Daniel said, from the scriptures. And now, I ask Pastor Day and I say, where will you say? I have this command to tell Corona. Where do you have your command? From our heads? From our feelings? Where? If Corona is Satan, then it's love in the past. One hour agenda, they don't even know what they are talking about. So it is up to us as the body of Christ to know exactly that. And again, let me mention this. This is now from my my mind, and I want to believe it is through the revelation of the Holy Spirit that from here, those who are serving God will serve God. Those who are not serving God will not, and there will be a clear cut.